Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let me show you how to use your MacBook as a scanner. So today's episode is really about how to be creative when using apps to get them to do things they weren't really meant to do. Like, for instance, suppose you have your MacBook and you're at a library and you find some pages of a book or document that you want to copy so you can refer to them later while doing research. Well, normally you might head over to the old Xerox machine and Xerox a couple pages and then add those to your notes. But if you have your MacBook with you, you have a camera in it. So why not take a picture of those pages with your MacBook's camera and then save them out as a PDF document. But in order to do this, you either need to use an app specialized for this or use just the things on your Mac but in a creative way. So here I am on my MacBook and I want to use the camera here to take pictures of pages of a book. So first I'm going to launch Photo Booth, which is the pre-installed app that allows you to use the camera. And now you can see what the camera sees. And I'm going to take a book here. I'm going to use my book as an example. And I'm going to put this in front of it. And I can click here and it'll give me a countdown. But a quicker way to do it would be to do Command and Option and T, which takes an instant photo. So I'm going to do that. Command Option T takes a photo of it. And now you can see it appear there. And I can flip to the next page. Take a photo of that. Notice the image is mirrored. It's because this is for taking pictures of you, not of pages in the book. But we'll take care of that. Great. Now I have three pictures here of the three different pages of the book. Now, if you were doing this for real, you'd probably take a lot more care to hold the book nice and steady and get a good clean shot. But I'm just doing this quickly as a demonstration. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select the images here. And I can hold the Shift key down and select all three of them. Then I'm going to do Edit Copy or Command C, which copies all three images to the buffer. I'm going to move to another app. I'm going to move to Preview. And Preview will then allow me to go File, New from Clipboard and actually create three documents at once. So you can see the clipboard is actually holding all three documents and now I have three documents total. And if you don't see the thumbnails there, make sure you turn on thumbnails and you can see 1, 2, 3. Now let's get rid of this mirroring here. You can see if I zoom in, it's mirrored. I can easily fix that by just going to Tools, Flip Horizontal. Now you can see it's the right way. And so let's do that for each of these pages, or I can actually select multiple ones here and flip them horizontal. So now I have actual the right way for each one here. So the next thing I want to do is select all of these, Command A for all, or just click and use the Shift key. And since these are separate documents, I want them to be one PDF document. So I'm actually going to print. And I have them all selected, so it's going to do three pages here. And I can decide whether I want it to auto-rotate or not. Let's have it auto-rotate, and then so it'll do it the long way there. And I can save it as a PDF here in the print dialog. But I could also just go Open PDF in Preview to just open this as a second document here in Preview. So now I can see what I've scanned in with my camera. It's a little blurry. I take a lot more care to get some good lighting and a good shot with the MacBook's camera. So I get a little clearer image there. So this is a good example of using functionality in various apps and combining them to accomplish something, like using your MacBook as a scanner. So using Photo Booth, you're able to take the pictures, and then using copy and paste functionality, you're able to get it over to Preview, and then using print as PDF functionality, you're able to combine them all together into a document. Now, of course, if you have an iOS device like an iPhone or an iPad, you can do this using an app and create a document from some photos. So there are a lot of different ways to do this, but this is one way to do it if all you have is a MacBook. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it'll just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.